They're like us. They are us. So what, their clothes are different and their weapons and food. Their hearts are the same. They fall in love. They worry about the weather and the crops, and they try to make their homes beautiful. Hello and welcome to Liam's Lyceum. I'm your host Liam, aka Himvar, and today we'll be doing a spoiler-free review of Nicola Griffith's Spear. Spear is a 2022 novella or novel by Nicola Griffith, and it is a short Arthurian tale. It's really very lovely. It's a story of a girl who starts with her mother and then finds love with another girl. There's mentioning of Irish gods, Lu, the Dagda, Morrigan, Nuada of the Silver Hand, Manann and Mac Lear. There's also Artos of Caer Leon, Lycan Sutcliffe's novel, Sword at Sunset. It was at his court that her destiny lies, actually. Of course, that is the take on Arthur here. The mood is very mythic. From a long time ago, whether late antiquity or early medieval, or, you know, maybe even your childhood. It's about the name of things and your own, as she doesn't even know her own name at first. But it's about growing up as well, and adolescence, puberty, seasons, nature, animals, and communication with them, love. And it's also about a spear, and this is Percival's story in a sense, and of the Grail, but it's not the Percival you know and are familiar with, probably. I enjoy this very much. Much more than Hild, which I had read first by Griffith. We get to explore some Romanic Celtic Britain with many peoples and Arthuriana with Welsh names, which is appropriate. What some would call a historical tale, but this has some fantasy elements. It also looked at disability and queer characters, of course. It really seemed inspired by Sutcliffe's Sword at Sunset with Arthur's name and a character with a limp. Griffith also referenced the story before in an interview I remember watching of her. There are things like Gyas, polyamory, Khaled Fulch, the Stone of Destiny, a certain cauldron, if you know what I'm talking about. A very interesting ending that looks at Arthur's lack of heir. The name references the protagonist rather than, the Guy Bolg or the Spear of Asaul, or what I was expecting more, Spear Rhone or Rhone Gomenyad or whatever. I'm not sure how to say that. My Welsh is non-existent pretty much. The speech on Angles, Saxons, and Jutes, Frisians, Yachts, etc. is beautiful and informed by present archaeology, but works as a great message on present immigration views and policy and whatnot. It's a very, very lovely read. It's very short, but honestly, very worth your time, I think. I enjoyed it a lot. Again, I enjoyed it a lot more than Hild, but after reading this, I very much am looking forward to reading more by Griffith, and hopefully it lives up to the, well, quality and enjoyment I had here with Spear. Anyways, Liam from Liam's Lyceum. I will catch you next time.